That was Fly Eagle Fly from the Lummi Nation. We started off with Eagle Takes Flight, also from the Lummi Nation. That was led by Avery Nelson. Avery, can you raise your hand? I would just like to honor the sacred eagle totem here that was brought in, and we got asked to sing that, and we thought that was the most appropriate song, and it was felt a lot of good energy in the room, so thank you very much, everybody, for listening to our songs. Cool.
Thank you very much. Let go, let go. We close the show for one stop. We close the place for New Jonathan, Colombia, Cohen, England, Norway. Heard a laugh in there somewhere. My name is Yelmer Winstab. My traditional name is Kithkrik. I'm Nucholas from Tlokwit, Huey, England and Norway. My mother and father are Jesse and Trent Mosu from Tlokwit. My grandparents are the late Alex and Nancy Mosu. And my mother's parents, Wayne and Jennifer Winstab, were still with us today. It's an honor to be here. I'd like to thank our host nation, for allowing us to be here, allowing us to do our cultural work, allowing us to carp with all these wonderful youth. And if there's any youth that are shy to not come up, if you worked on this, anyone, you come up here and stand with us. These are the people who made this. Let's hear it for them. It was an honor gifted to myself from the association here, from the collective I work with, the Unified Aboriginal Youth Collective, from all of the youth here, our elders, our hosts, the nation who hosts us here as visitors. We were given the honor to drive this piece of cedar from my territory of Tlokwit to Fino. My family, my mother and my brother and I here, we went out and got it, we cut those boards and we brought it this way. And we brought it this way so all these young people could carve it. Could carve it for the young people of here. The young people that of this land, of this territory, play late today. The young people that hosted us and kept our hearts so warm and our bellies full. It's such an honor to stand here with all these young people, with all these leaders, all these elders, and with our gift here of cedar, of our totem pole. We went and sat in the Friendship Center and we talked about what we should do, what we should carve, what we should create. And an eagle is what we wanted to carve. We hold this eagle feather, my grandfather's eagle feather that he gave to my little brother. This eagle feather was passed to all of these youth here when they introduced themselves in their language, when they spoke, when they laughed, when they sang. We found relatives. I found a brother here when we carved. And we carved this eagle to take those prayers up to the Creator, to take those prayers of all these young people. It's sitting on top of a cedar box, and within that cedar box are hundreds and hundreds of prayers. People wrote out prayers or thoughts, and they put them inside that box. The elders and the youth, they made tobacco. They put their prayers in that tobacco, and they put it in that box just before we came up here. Daisy, they put their prayers in that box. Everyone here put their prayers together. People from home, people from here, as a gift for these young people that hosted us, that did that wonderful work to lift all of our spirits up. Everyone here led. I stood back. I didn't have to do one thing, and they led us, and they led us, and they led us. And as the day went on, when the second day came, the room was just full of love. You could feel it. You walked in the room, and everyone felt good. All these gentlemen, these ladies, the life givers, they all made this with so much love. And we talked about that before we started carving. We said, when we're working with cedar, and we put all those good thoughts in there, it'll be a good totem pole. It'll be a good gift. And they poured so much love and so much honor and respect into this gift here. For the youth of Tlaleitene and to the Native Friendship Center here in Prince George. They hosted us so well when we were carving. They brought us food. They laughed with us. They sat with us. We passed this eagle feather around. One of the workers, our Colin, sat with us all day the first day, all day the second day until it was finished. He didn't leave until it was finished. And it's such an honor to have all these leaders here. And I'd like to stand all these people up. I'd like to ask all of you to rise and stand and honor all these young people for the work that they did. The work that they did to follow their protocol. The work that they did to honor the people of this land, of Tlaleitene. To honor the Friendship Center and the good work they do. And gathering our voices in the good work they did. For that box, we gathered our voices and we gathered our prayers. And this is a gift here. I'd also like to thank Jeff for all the work he's done in making this a reality. The honor he's given myself. And we were worrying about how to do it right. We knew we had to do it right. And Paul stood up and made sure that happened. And I'd really like to honor Paul as well. My little brother here wants to end. When we started this carving, we started with a prayer that my brother wrote for the cedar. And I'd like to pass this mic to him to do that final prayer. And as he does that, we gathered all the wood chips that had come off this pole with all this love and all that good feeling in it. And we'd like to hand them out to all the youth here. And we're going to leave some at the front at that table when you leave. If you'd like to take a little bit of this totem pole hole with you, take it back to your territory. It's medicine for our people. And so we're going to hand those out as my little brother sings his prayer song that he wrote for collecting cedar bark for that cedar tree. He started it off before we carved with this prayer, and we'd like to end it with this prayer. I'm honored to be here, to laugh with you, to smile with you. And with that, I'd like to give this to my brother, Kleko, Kleko, Chu.
Kuklashis Timothy Masu, Nuchonthak Kloquit. Hello, my name is Timothy Masu. I'm from Nuchonthak Kloquit. My parents are Trent and Jesse Masu. My grandparents are Alec and Nancy Masu, and Wayne and Jennifer Winstop. I wrote this song for collecting cedar bark. Now I'd like to sing it today. Ahumis, Mishter Kumis, Wiksha. Mr. Kumis, Wiksha.